Hey everybody, it's me, Zach Rickey, and you're watching Pranksters!
When your back is turned, here comes a prank, you're gonna get burned. Here comes a prank, when the worm is turned, your lesson will be learned, you're watching Pranksters!
Welcome to Pranksters! We have another totally awesome episode for you today. Totally awesome if you dig pranks, that is. If you're some Stiffly Stifferson who has a prank coming your way, you might not be as psyched. But all this talking is making me feel like a grown-up. So let's bring out our first prankster, Dwayne Hosey.
Oh my God, I am so glad to be here. Zach Rickey, you are the man, the man.
What can I say? I love me my pranks. Now why don't you tell us about your target?
Well, his name is Mr. Boddicker, and he teaches math. And let me tell you, I hate math.
Well, thanks to Prankster Hidden Camera Technology, we can take a look at what happened.
Okay, there are two things you should know about Mr. Boddicker. He loves almonds, and he hates snakes.
I have a feeling I'm gonna like this. Better watch out, Mr. Boddicker.
Sure enough, my plan worked perfectly.
Oh, boy. Oh! Whammy, blammy, wowie, zowie, you've just been pranked.
I got you, Mr. Boddicker.
Thanks for stopping by, Dwayne. I guess there's a new lesson for you, Mr. Boddicker. Never yank a prankster. Now let's bring out our next prankster, Chuck Gordon.
Oh man, Zach Rickey, this is the thrill of a lifetime.
You know, it's a rare treat when we get an older prankster, Chuck. Thanks for coming.
Well, I found Pranky late in life, but it means a whole lot to me.
Well, I'd love to hear it. Now tell us about your target.
Well, I'll tell you, Zach. He's my neighbor Jerry, and he keeps borrowing my tools without returning them. This guy has Stiffly Stifferson written all over him.
Sounds like he was just asking for a pranking, Chuck. Well, let's take a walk down Prankster Lane.
Well, last Sunday I reached my breaking point, so I hid in Jerry's garage.
Let me guess, Jerry hates spiders.
What really steams me is how he treats the tools like they're his. They're not his, Zach, they're mine.
Oh boy, I can just tell that this is gonna be good.
Him into a million pieces, Zach.
What did you do?
I pranked him with a chainsaw. Whammy, whammy, blammy, wowie, zowie.
I don't believe what I just saw.
I know. I can't believe how much prank juice came out of him when I pranked him in half. Buckets. I was covered in it.
I need to call the police.
No, Zach. I would not do that. You know who calls police, don't you? Stiffly Stifferson's, Zach.
Ted, let's lose the sound effects. Because it's inappropriate.
I can't thank you enough, Zach. This idea wouldn't have even occurred to me if it wasn't for your wonderful show.
Ted!
Never yank a prankster, right, Zach? I really think I have a shot to win the Pranky this year.
We need to have a talk. Because first of all, you gotta watch these clips beforehand. A man is dead.
I can't tell you how disappointed I am with your Stiffly Stifferson tone. Because I so hate Stiffly Stifferson.
I'm not a Stiffly Stifferson.
Well, good, because I could prank you for a month before you begged me to prank you out of your misery.
Well, I wish there was a way to summarize tonight's episode of Pranksters. Hope to see you next week.